I know you're anxious to get started with this experiment, but before we can do any real work, we want to take the time to calibrate the pH probe. This process is pretty straightforward. It's something we expect you'll have to do perhaps later in the semester or at some point in your career. So I'll do this process for you, I'll record it, and I'd expect you to watch it at least, 4,000 times so that you would be good at it, assuming you had to do it yourself in the future. That is, of course, provided this quarantine has ever ended and we're allowed to all go out and do work again. So here I have the pH probe, our LabQuest, and calibrating solutions of pH 7 and pH 4. Solutions which, by the way, we keep in the stockroom next to loaf potion number 9. So, here we go. We're going to start by opening up the calibration screen by tapping on calibrate. And then, of course, we want to go about calibrating our probe. We'll choose calibrate now. And then we'll take our pH probe and immerse it into the pH 7 buffer solution. Before I do that, however, I'll take the time to rinse off the probe using liberal amounts of deionized water. Then I'll carefully dab the probe so as to remove any excess water. This blotting process is performed while keeping mindful of the very delicate glass electrode at the tip. Once I've blotted the water away, I dip the probe into the pH 7 buffer solution and I swirl. In the same, I'll type onto the screen a value of 7. And then hit keep once the line voltage, which appears on the screen, is stable. It's stable. I hit keep. And then I'll prepare the pH probe for the second buffer solution. I'll remove the probe from the buffer and I'll rinse it off liberally with large amounts of deionized water. Then I'll take yet a new chem wipe, and again, I'll blot the electrode dry, wipe off any excess water, and place the probe into the pH 4 buffer solution. I'll swirl, and again, wait for the line voltage, which appears on the screen, to stabilize. At that point, I can type a pH value 4, which represents the buffer's pH, and keep. This two-point calibration, not always essential for the use of these probes, is a typical step for most probes. That said, notice we now have the pH reading on the screen at 3.99, if not 4.00, as one would expect, given that I'm still immersed in the pH 4 buffer. This process of washing off the probe and blotting the electrode is to be performed every time the electrode is removed from a solution and before it's immersed into a new solution. You'll be going through a lot of the chem wipes. That said, these chem wipes, which a lot of students use for tissues, probably could be used as toilet paper given that the fact you can't find toilet paper at all in the stores anymore. Probably not septic safe, but I'll tell you what, when you need it, you need it. Know what I mean?